Hello friends, welcome to CYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. So in which we are covering your prelims part as well as mains part. So currently we have 6 series of prelims and one of main series. One series is oriented towards your mains of CSC. That will be conducted in September, October most probably. So already the date of the calendar of events of UPSC is released in advance by UPSC, so you can check the date. So the prelims date is 2nd June. So in these series, what we do question answer approach. We give you questions, then we give you answers, and in this way we cover your syllabus in a question answer format. So the topic of discussion in today's video is the mains answer writing topic. So friends, I am actually going somewhere, so I am out of station. If there is some disturbance coming in the video, then please bear with us. Actually, I have to go for some important work. So friends, let's talk about the questions of today that are let's see them. What are the questions of today that you have to write? The first question is, illegal coal mining in Northeast is rampant and tragedies happening there haven't acted as deterrent because of lack of accountability of the stakeholders. You have to comment on this question, and you have to comment on this in 250 words, and the maximum marks are 15. So recently you know that in Meghalaya a coal mining tragedy has happened, in which a certain number of individuals are trapped in the mine, in the coal mine, underground coal mine. So rescue efforts are already ongoing, but there is no clue that where they are and whether they are alive or not. So that about in that context I have made a question, because these instances happen repeatedly in Northeast area. Already the coal mining has been banned by National Green Tribunal in 2014, but the illegal coal mining goes on, and there is no regulatory provision to control it, and due to which also the poor people, who are mostly the migratory laborers, they suffer from such disasters. So you have to comment on it. The second question is, what are the essential features of the Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill 2017, and why some feminists are criticizing it? So friends, you know that the government has recently approved in Lok Sabha the Muslim Woman Bill 2017 that is related to triple talaq, but certain feminists are opposing this bill as they are saying that it is retrogressive and it is not addressing the needs of the Muslim women, and it is in fact putting them in more danger. So you have to tell me tell in the answer the essential features, as well as you have to explain the reasons that why some feminists or other or NGOs that are associated with the women empowerment are criticizing it. So you have to tell in 250 words, and the marks, maximum marks are 15 marks. Now the third question is, that is the last question. So third question is related to your static portion. So as I have already told you that in this initiative we cover 3 questions, and 2 are current oriented and 1 is static oriented, and the static question is given to you from the topic which is told to you in advance. So the topic of today was architecture. So of medieval India, already we have covered 2 questions from the architecture of ancient India, and today the question is from the architecture of medieval India. So the question is, the dawn of Sultanate in Delhi can be equated with the watershed moment in the evolution of architecture of medieval India. So you have to comment on you have to make a comment on this statement in 150 words, and the maximum marks are 10 marks. So friends who are new to this channel, who are seeing the video for the first time, let me explain to them that what is this basically, what initiative is this basically. So it is an initiative that is run by us, that is Team Achieve IAS. So we daily give you 3 questions, and you have to write answers, and you have to give us to you for evaluation, because friends, ultimately the problem lies with the evaluation. You can write, then who will tell you that you are writing in the right sense or not, and whether you are mentioning the right point or whether you are off the track. So all these things are important while you are preparing for UPSC CSC mains, and for that thing we have started this initiative, because already questions are much on the net But the problem is of evaluation. There are many websites, I know about them, you also may know about them, that they post daily questions, but the problem is of evaluation by experts, because the evaluation there done is done by the students itself, and the students are themselves in the preparing stage. So it is difficult to get the expert viewpoint. So already we are in this field from 5 years. So due to this experience, we are guaranteeing you that we will evaluate your answer in a proper manner so that you can get the proper feedback. So in this, we also provide you people a reference material that, for example, if today the questions of today, you will get the reference material tomorrow. So if you don't know the answer of a particular question, then you will get the reference material tomorrow and you can read it in detail, and this will give you enough idea that you can write about that topic in 250 or 150 words as the word limit of the question may prescribe. So let's check what is the fee structure of this initiative. So friends, basically the fee structure is 1,000 rupees per month. If you want to subscribe to for 1 month, you have to pay just 1,000 rupees. But in case you want to subscribe in a package format, that is for 4 months, we are offering you a discount of ₹800. That is this initiative will be available to you in ₹3,200. And for 3 months, it is available in ₹2,700, and a discount of ₹300 is available for the complete package. So it is your choice. You can join for a month also, and then you can check her quality. And also you can join for 4 months as a package, and then you will get a discount of ₹800. And you can join for 3 months also, and accordingly you will get the discount ₹300. So if you want to subscribe to this initiative, then you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. Already 25 to 30 students are linked with us through this initiative. So we have a team of experts that evaluate your answers and check your answers from diverse viewpoints, because UPSC ultimately demands multiple angles from answer. So each answer is checked by multiple experts that we have in our team. So for the purpose of subscription, if you want to subscribe, you can WhatsApp us at this given number, 8968426481. So this is all about, friends, today's video. So if you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends if you find it valuable, and please please subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the notifications of the initiatives that we do on YouTube. So thank you, friends, thank you very much.